feel like I've fought all my life for this. This one part, this one third, I've always missed.
Hello folks, this is Ayat Rancha from InspiredRise.com, and today we are going to do a full detailed review of the Honor 6X smartphone. I have already been using this smartphone since past 1 month, and this is my full review for this one. The Honor 6X comes with a 5.5-inch 1080p display. The viewing angles are good, but if I have to state a con, I would say that the colors look very little bit washed out, but still overall it's a good display and it is visible even in quite bright light. And when using the smartphone, the 5.5-inch certainly adds to the overall experience, because this smartphone has a very nice metallic body and the sides are curved. So when you hold the smartphone in hand, the overall feel is good. The glass is also curved. So overall feel while using the smartphone comes out to be good. It has a 3340mAh battery, Kirin 655 chipset, which is an octa-core chipset. You get 4GB of RAM and 12MP camera along with a 2MP depth sensing camera. So what happens with this one is that you are able to select from a wide aperture to a shallow aperture, and the wide to small aperture variation allows you to have a really nice depth of field effect in your photographs, and you can see all of that in our detailed camera review for the Honor 6X. We have already done a detailed gaming review also for the Honor 6X, so you can see the gaming performance and everything else in detail over in that video, which is in the description below. And I would just like to summarize it for you that the gaming performance is top notch. I was able to play almost every game with ease. The smartphone didn't lag or didn't hang at any place, and 4GB RAM coupled with 655 chipset was good enough for my day-to-day activities and needs. Now let's take a look at the benchmark scores for this smartphone.
I'm drowning in the fears, and now I know that I will fall again and let it go.
If I talk about the battery life for this smartphone, I was able to use it for 1 day even with really heavy usage, and when I used it on a moderate basis, I was easily able to get 2 days, or if you are really conservative, you might even push it to 3. And this is because of the 3340mAh battery, which is not that much high in terms of on paper specification, but the thing is that the EMUI is quite optimized, and therefore the overall experience of using the smartphone, and with the additional power saver profiles and different power profiles and battery manager etc. present in the smartphone, the overall battery life is really quite high in real world scenario. If I talk about the design cons, I would say that one of the design achievements of the smartphone is also one of the design flaws. This smartphone is quite slippery in hand because it has a very nice finish. It does look really good, but it is quite slippery, and even from my hand, I'm a very nice gentle user, but even from my hand I dropped the smartphone around 3 times. So I would say that if you are going to buy this smartphone, do use it with caution, because it is quite smooth, too much smooth I would say. If I have to nitpick the few cons that this smartphone has, then I would say that if we talk about the camera takes really great photos and overall the bokeh effect etc. is quite good, but the colors in the images are a little bit undersaturated. It does look like a washed out film grain type of effect on all of the images. And one serious error that I found was that when I switched on the HDR mode, the images were really overexposed. So if I had a red flower, it changed to a deep shade of pink. So this is one of the things that Honor needs to work on. Their smartphones are really good, the camera is really good. I didn't find any single issue to complain about, but the thing is that few of these small issues do strike up as big when the smartphone experience is really that good. So this is one of those things that Honor really needs to work on, that the image processing in their camera application really needs some improvement. And I would also like to say that a smartphone like Redmi Note 3 had 4K video recording, then Honor guys should have kind of tried to include 4K video recording in this smartphone, though I would say that it's like asking for too much. But still, if they had incorporated 4K video recording, this would have been an ultimate camera smartphone.
We also have brilliant offers with SBI. You can see here 10% cash back for all those in SBI, so that adds on to whatever you see here. We also have a wonderful offer of 14GB with the Airtel. So those two great offers coupled with the Kindle offer here, So let's have a look at 3GB plus 32GB. Are you ready? Are you ready?
Yeah!
No, are you ready?
Yeah!
Okay. There we go. You got it right. Good. 9999. And the 4GB plus 64GB. Are you ready?
14.
There you go.
For the price of sub $250, the Honor 6X is one of those budget smartphones that has a good camera, good display, good battery life, decent software experience, though I am still waiting for Android Nougat on this one, and once they update it to Android Nougat, then maybe the overall experience would become even more smoother. Even right now it's good, but Nougat is the flavor of the season, so I'm still eagerly waiting for that update. News is that Honor 8 would also get that update soon, in maybe by the end of February. So we are still waiting for that one for Honor 6X. And if you consider all of the other factors, then Honor 6X is one of those smartphones that you can go and buy without hesitation, because the build quality is good, everything on the smartphone does feel top notch, and the overall experience is good. If you compare it with smartphones in the same price bracket like the Coolpad Cool One Dual or the Redmi Note 4, then I would like to point out that Redmi Note 4 does not have a dual camera. So in terms of performance, it might be a better smartphone, but you don't get the same camera proposition as the Honor 6X. And when you compare it with Cool One Dual, then I would say that Cool One Dual is also a very great smartphone for a very great price. And the Honor 6X is also a very great smartphone for a very great price. But if we compare the flagship feature of both of these smartphones to take good bokeh type of shots, then the Honor 6X shots look more natural as compared to the Cool One Dual shots. The Cool One Dual shots look like really high software processing. So that's the difference between both of these smartphones. So guys, this was it for this video. In case you like this one, don't forget to smash that thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more awesome videos like this. This is Aditya Rancha from inspiredwise.com. Signing off, folks. Stay inspired.